Art Attack. This is Art Attack. Welcome once again to Art Attack, the big art show that gives your eyeballs a shock. Whatever you do, don't throw away your old comics. Come and have a look at this. Take an envelope and carefully tear apart the glued joints. Open it out and then mark along the edges where the glue was. Just put that to one side. Bring in a coloured double page spread from your favourite comic. Put the envelope back on top and then just carefully use it as a pattern to draw around the edge onto your comic. It doesn't matter which side of the comic you draw on, but we'll be using the coloured side. Although you can use a black and white side. In fact, you could do this on newspaper, wallpaper, any type of paper. There it is, and you have that pattern. Cut that out, and you'll have something that looks like that. And fold it back again, like the original envelope, same places, down that side, and that flap there. And then mark with an X on the same lines as those glued edges on the original envelope. And then put some glue on those edges. The reason I've marked them is so I know which ones to put glue on. Fold them over. Stick them down, and there you have a multicoloured comic strip envelope. Looks brilliant, doesn't it? And let's face it, if that came through your letterbox, it'd certainly give your eyeballs a shock. But I haven't finished yet. You can also make some great greetings cards to go inside the envelopes. Make a card out of thin card or thick paper, and make it so it's the right size to go inside the envelope. And on the front, stick a picture from your comic, preferably a big picture, so it covers almost the whole of the front of your card. And then take a piece of paper and draw on it two speech bubbles or balloons. Just draw them roughly, because you're going to cut them out so you have a shape that looks something like that. And put a dab of glue on the back. And again, you can do it more carefully than I am. I'm just doing it quickly to show you. And just stick it on the front of your card with a speech bubble coming out of the character's mouth. And then you can take a black felt tip pen and just carefully go around the edges of your speech bubble. Just down the side there, so it looks like it's coming out of your character's mouth. And just to give it a professional finish, go around the outside of your card. You can use a ruler. Doesn't matter if the lines aren't that straight, because they're not usually that straight in comics. They're usually zany and rather wacky. And then use the speech bubble to write the message on the front of your card and the address on the front of your envelope. And there you have a multicoloured comic strip card and matching envelope.
What a great way to use up your old comics.
Hello. Guess who? Yes, it's me, the head. Of course, he nicked that idea. Nicked it from me. I've been wrapping up my presents in comics for years, and they look great. I'll bet you'll never guess what this is. Do you give up? It's a pair of football boots.
Oh, that's very nice, is that? A Chinese dragon. Hey, I've done one of those. I have done a real masterpiece out of red lentils. You've got to see this.
This is a real cheeky art attack. Just take a look at this beautiful calligraphy. This was done with black ink. This one was done with red poster paint watered down. And look at that fabulous split letter effect. And you're not going to believe how I did those letters. Take a ruler and draw a line across a piece of paper, across the top of the ruler, and then another line across the bottom of the ruler, and then just move the ruler about 1.5 to 2 centimetres up and draw another line. And these are guidelines to practice small and taller letters. Now, I'm not going to use expensive calligraphy pens or brushes. I am going to use my favourite ice lolly. That's all you need, your favourite ice lolly. And the first thing to do is eat it. Save the stick and then carefully snap the stick in half. And there you have 2 calligraphy pens for lolly lettering. And take some ink, just ordinary fountain pen ink, or ready-mixed poster paint that you mix with a lot of water so it's nice and runny. And let me just give you a tip. Hold the stick exactly like you were holding a fountain pen. Forget that it's a stick, hold it like a pen. Dip it into your ink, and then start to practice your lolly lettering. Another tip here, just keep all of the snapped end of your stick on the paper, and you get this fantastic thick and thin effect on your lettering. Look at that, a fancy flick there as well. And with a bit of practice, you will discover all the different effects and stars that you can achieve with a lolly stick. Let's do one more there. Just show you that. And again, all the time, I'm just keeping the whole of this snapped end onto the paper to create thick, thin, thick again, and then I'll flick for thin. Look at that. Now sometimes when you snap a lolly stick, you get this splintered sort of jagged edge. Well, don't throw that away, because that can be used to good effect. Now I'll just dip this into the ink, shake the excess off, and watch this. You get a smashing sort of split letter effect. There it is. Just do it a bit more up top, and again, I'll give it another flick. Another way to create split letter is to take your lolly stick and just snip a notch right in the middle of your stick, but be careful if you're using the old scissors like this. You've just got a little notch in the end there. Again, dip it into the ink, shake off the excess, and you'll notice I have to keep dipping into the ink. That's all right. That's how the old calligraphy artists did it. And do your letter. And there it goes. It's your split in the middle. And if you snap a couple of sticks, you can make a whole set of calligraphy pens. Try it yourself. It's great fun to do and a very cheeky art attack. Lolly lettering.
What a fabulous thing to do with your lolly sticks. And it's all down to practice. Hey, I've done one of them. Only I forgot to eat the lolly first.
My name's Stephanie. I made this picture by drawing round shapes and then I cut them out. I splattered 3 colours over the shapes with 2 toothbrushes. This is what it looks like underneath.
Hello, my name is Kerry. I did this splatter painting by first of all choosing 3 different geometrical shapes. This is what it looks like underneath.
What a fantastic art attack from Borough Green Primary School. Making stencils by cutting shapes out of cardboard or paper and flicking paint through the holes. You can use an ordinary paintbrush to flick paint, or you can do what the guys at Borough Green School did, and you can use an old toothbrush, just like this one I'm using. That's just a case of dipping your toothbrush into your paint, and then flicking. This is a great technique. It's also great fun to do as well. And the finished result looks something like that. Look at that. And in fact, this technique is called spatter. Maybe it should have been called splatter. Well, you can also use the shapes that you cut out as sort of masks so that you can flick paint around them. Just like this. Out some shapes, flick some paint, and give yourself a stencil and mask attack. And I'll see you next time. Ta-ra!